Good afternoon, student, and here I am once again with you to explain the remaining part of the lesson, The Treasure Within, written by Miss Bela Raja. Now children, earlier I told you that every child has a hidden talent in themselves. Every child is capable of doing something big in her or his life. Only thing, the child has to identify that part. Only thing, the child has to recognize that he is good in what. If he is good in dancing, then practice dancing every day. Let the whole world know that you are a good dancer. If you are good at singing, please sing every day. Let the whole world know that you are a very good singer. So, but this nobody else can do for you. Only you, and you are the only one to recognize your talent or capability. So in this lesson, as the interviewer is Mrs. Bela Raja, and she has gone to take to the interview of a very famous personality, Hafiz Contractor. And he had also, in his interview, he had told everything in a very honest and sincere manner. He has told everything to the interviewer. Now, as I told you, Miss Bela Raja told that every child is capable of doing things, something great, and he can become a hero in the area of his interest. What is needed more is to discover the things within himself, his talent or aptitude. Hafiz is a living example of such hero. And children, I think we all know, after reading this lesson, I think 3/4 lesson I have completed, we all know that Hafiz Contractor was a leading architect in India. He lives in Mumbai. Now, in the first part, I have told you about his school life and as a child what he used to do and about his school life. We all know from the first part of the lesson that he was not a good student. He used to play prank on others, and moreover, he was his concentration was somewhere else. He never used to pay attention in his studies. So people used to think that he is a dull child, but actually it is not the case. This we will know when we will read the other two part of the story. Children, we all know that he took interest in games and playing practical jokes on other. He was also having a helping attitude. If some student used to go with some problem, he immediately used to help them. So that's why he was a hero among the student lobby. But later on, one sentence was spoken to him by the principal of the school which changed his life. When he was in the 11th standard, the principal said to Hafiz, was a good student but little interest in studies. She has identified that child intelligent. That means he was intelligent. He was not a dull child like the other teachers were thinking, as he was getting very less marks. So he is telling that, but he has lost interest in his studies. The principal had taken care of him till that day, but now he could no longer take care of him. He wanted to say, till now we were taking care because you were small. Now we cannot take care. Now you have to take care of yourself, because now you are in higher classes. We should study hard. He also told that only sports won't take him very far away in his life. Okay, so this was the hint given to him by the principal that he is an intelligent student and he can do very well in his studies. Now let's see the other part of the lesson. Let's continue the other part of the lesson. So I've already explained you this page. Okay, and I told you that earlier he had a friend. I'm starting from here. Yes, he had a friend. He was called Behram Devicha. This all part I have done with you in the previous video. This all part we have done. So I told you that he had a friend who was known as Behram Divicha, and one day they had competition between them that who will design the best forts, guns and ammunition. Now they also decided that they would not design like they used to design earlier. They will design something much better. They will make an effort to do something much better than the early what they used to in their drawing earlier. Now in school, when I was in the second or third standard, one of my teacher, Mrs. Gupta, saw my sketches and told me, "See, you are useless in everything else, but your sketches are good. When you grow up, you become an architect." I did not know at the time, but she was right. Later, after I became an architect, I went back to meet her and tell her. Now, a teacher was there, and that teacher told him what? That teacher told him that when she saw his sketches, she told him that you are not good in everything, you are useless in everything, but your sketches are wonderful. It is very good. And one day you can become a good architect. Now, first of all, what is an architect? Architect is a person who designs and who made a plan for a building, for a hospital, for a bridge, anything which can be constructed. So that he used to make bridges, he used to make building, railway station, hotels, nursing homes, okay, shopping complex. So a good architect, first he draw a map, a well planned map, then he has to see a lot of things in the building like ventilation system, the drainage system, etc. So that is known as architect. That means whatever construction work is going to do, it should be something very good, and the plan should be made in a very calculative manner. That's why maths is needed in the subject like architect. So the interview, she asked him that, "Why do you think you did not like studies? Was it because you felt you could not cope, could not deal with the curriculum?" So, she asked him, "Why do you think you did not like studies? Was it because you felt you could not cope, could not deal with the curriculums?" "I was very bad at language." Now the interviewer question was that, "You did not like studies, or do you feel the curriculum, the syllabus was very vast and you could not cope up with the syllabus?" So what he gave his answer in a very honest way, in a very serious way. And what he told him, he told that, "I was very bad at languages, and definitely science and geography were the only subject I could deal with. That means I was rather interested in science and geography. Maths was very bad." Now he told very honestly everything to the interview. He told his maths was very bad. "I just was not interested. I was studying for the sake of studying." So he told, "I was in fact not interested in studies. I was only interested because I have to study. Because like other child, we're going to the school for studies." So even he told, "Even I have to go to the school for studies." And I was completing my education. I did not have any interest for study. "What they taught me today, I would forget after 2 days." So they told, "What they taught me today," that means whatever they taught him today, that he will forget after 2 days. This was his scenario every day. That means what student? He never used to revise the things. He never used to pay attention in the class, as well as he never used to revise. Because if you will revise and if you will study seriously, you cannot forget your lessons. So, "I just was not interested. I was studying for the sake of studying. What they taught me today, I would forget after 2 days." I would not bother because there was no application of mind there to begin with. Now, he told that I would forget all those things the teacher taught me after 2 days. And then I would not bother also because there was no application of mind there to begin with. In fact, he thought ki there was nothing hard to study. He could have managed any time. So this was his thought against the studies. Now the interviewer asked him, did you think that what they taught in school was boring? Or did you feel that when you understood the concept of what was being taught, you lost interest in the rest of the lesson? So this time, Ms. Bela Raja asked him that, do you feel whatever the studies was taught to you in the school was boring? Or you feel that once you understand the concept of what was being taught, you lost interest in the rest of the lesson? Now children, there are many children are like that, they don't want to study line by line. They only understand the concept, the summary of the lesson, and they think that everything is over. So it was with Hafiz also, he never is to study anything very seriously. In fact, he was never interested in studies. So the teacher, the interviewer is asking this thing to him. Living in a boarding school is difficult. We were just living from day to day. He's told ki living itself in a boarding school was a very difficult thing. Nowadays, there are so many tests. Back then, whenever we had tests, we used to just copy. Now he's telling ki nowadays, so many tests are there a student has to face. But earlier time, very less test used to be there, and they simply used to cheat. The teacher thought that we had done our work, and the teacher was under impression that the child had done their work honestly. There is concentration, there is contention that giftedness and learning disabilities go hand in hand. So children, the meaning of contention is to believe something. So see here, the meaning of contention is to believe something. Okay, to have an argument with. So he's telling at that time, the interview is asking him, do you think that you are that gifted children, some child have a hidden talent, they are God gifted children, and some have learning disabilities like Hafiz Raja when he was a contractor. So Hafiz Raja, he did not feel like a study, but it was God gifted intelligence to him. The person who did hate maths, he was not good in maths, has chosen a subject which he cannot complete without maths. So maths was God gifted to him, though he was having learning disability. That means he never used to practice maths when he was a child. So the interviewer is asking, this also applies to you? Well, take some student from my class. Those who always stood first or second are today doing very ordinary job. Now Hafiz contractor, he replied that many people are here who were very good in studies, okay, but they stood first and second in the class. They used to do very well in the examination, but now they are doing a very ordinary job. So it's not that ki the person who is very intelligent, they will be doing the best. Bela Raja, I have come across a situation in so many different places where people tell me that their class toppers are doing very ordinary today. Now Miss Bela Raja also supported him by telling, yes, I have gone to many places where somebody told me that the topper of the class is doing some ordinary job. They are very doing some ordinary things today. Hafiz contractor, in school, I think living our lives there made us street smart. I never learned more by doing what I did on my own than what academics would have taught me. Now children, he told in a very frank manner, in a very blunt manner, he gave this interview. To the interview, he told that he did not feel this thing that it is the academic thing we only have to give important. He is told ki whatever used to come to his mind, which was non-academic, related with non-academic thing, that thing he was rather interested in doing than to study. So it is not that it is the only person who are good in academics, they will do something good in their life. In school, I think living our lives there made us street smart. Huh? He told ki the school life has, because due to school life, we have become very smart. I have learned more by doing what I did on my own. He told ki whatever I used to think and do it, I have learned from that thing. Instead of learning what academics would have taught me, he said, instead of learning from academics, whatever I used to do it, that helped me to become a good contractor. Now children, you can see the part of a building which he has constructed. You can see this building constructed by Hafiz Raza. How nicely, you see, in the semicircular design he has constructed the basement of the building, and you can see the tall tower like building. So it is a shopping complex designed by Hafiz contractor. You can see the beauty of the building. Okay, now Miss Bela Raja is asking, that is because the personality and skills were there. You were able to find expression in a manner you were comfortable with, and you defied every rule so that nobody would stop you from doing what you needed to do. Now he is telling that the interview is asking him, that is because the personality and skills were there, that your personality was also like that and you had a nice skill. You were able to find expression in a manner you were comfortable with. Now he is telling ki you, in what thing you used to feel comfortable, only in that thing you used to feel nice. Nobody used to compel to do the things. So children, suppose why he became a good architect, suppose it used to be rainy season, this I will be teaching you later. And he used to think not about the rainy season, he used to think when the water overflow from the river, then how he will build it, build to stop that overflowing of the water. So such was the brain of that small child, which was, so what according what I feel, that he was not an ordinary child but a very extraordinary child. So she is telling that you were interested in what your mind used to tell you. If you want to do that something else apart from the studies, if you wanted to do, then you used to complete that thing. So she is asking ki I was more, Hafiz is telling, I was more interested in other thing. If for example while in class it started raining outside, I would think of the flowing water and how to build a dam to block it. Now see, this example is here with you. He is telling, if it would be raining outside the class, my mind used to deviate from the study and I used to think what? I used to think of the flowing water and how to build a dam to block it. So children, this a ordinary child, a normal child does not think like that. He can only think, can only enjoy the rainfall. He can think about the board, the paper boards. Okay. He can see the beautiful scenery, but he will never think the way Hafiz contractor used to think. So what he used to think? That the flowing water and how to build a dam to block it. I would be thinking about the flow of water within the dam and how much of water the dam would be able to hold. So children, see how peculiar was his mind. What other was thinking, he was different from the other student. He is telling, I would be thinking about the flow of water within the dam and how much of water the dam would be able to hold. That was my interest for the day. So whole day he used to think the same thing, how he would be stopping water from the dam, how can the dam hold the water. So the whole day he used to think like that. Well, he gives you example that how extraordinary child he was. When a student lost a button while playing or fighting, children, when any student used to lose his button, losing button means just going against the discipline of the school. So that child used to come running to him. So when the student lost a button while playing or fighting, they would come running to me and I would cut a button from them from chalk using a blade. So see how clever he was. See how intelligent ही वॉज. वेन ए चाइल्ड यूज टू कम टू हिम कंप्लेनिंग डैट ही हैड लॉस्ट हिज बटन इन फाइट और इन प्लेइंग, तो दे वुड कम टू हिम बिकॉज दे नो डैट इफ द बटन विल नॉट देयर द टीचर वुड पनिशमेंट. डैट बटन वॉज ए मेजर पार्ट ऑफ द यूनिफॉर्म. चिल्ड्रन विदाउट बटन used to get punishment. So this child, they used to come running to him, and what, how Hafiz used to help him. See his wonderful idea. If any other child would have been in his place, they would have denied this thing. But what Hafiz used to do, he would cut in a button from them. He would cut a button for them from chalk using a blade. So in and anyhow, maybe with the help of the Fevicol or maybe anyhow used to stick that button on the shirt. So in this way, he became the hero among the students. The teacher lobby didn't used to like him because they feel that he's not a good in studies and he is a nuisance in the class. But he was hero among the students. Discipline in the school was very important, and no student could afford to have a button missing. That means missing a button means going against the discipline. So no child would even dare to come and sit in the class without a button. The student would get past dinner with a full neat uniform, and after that it did not matter. Now children, even the dinner in the dinner time, the student in the uniform used to be checked. Only the student with a full neat uniform, they used to get the dinner. And though, however, it becomes dirty, nobody would know, nothing matters. But till the time of the dinner, the student should be proper and neat. Coming to the present, how do you decide as to what kind of structure you want to give a client? Now, he is telling children, clients have different tastes, clients have different choices. One like ice cream, the other like dosa. Okay, so he's telling, so is the case with house. If one like a French bungalow, the other would like a two-story building or a three-story building. One would like a small house with a nice garden, so the other would like to have a flowers and garden in the terrace. So various taste of the clients varies. So the question is put to him, coming to the present, how do you decide as to what kind of structure you want to give it client? Now children, clients, they have to pay a lot for to the architecture when they are asked to make the map. They charge a lot because drawing a house map for somebody's house is not an easy thing. He has to see a lot of things, the places where the doors are, where the entrance gates are. Okay, how safe it would be in all the season, rain, fall, sun, summer, winter. Then many other things, the ventilation system, the light system. Okay, and then the, like I told you that he was the one who told that this window is not going to get, will not be open. And it was his cousin's husband who then told him that you forget everything, but you go and become a architect. In fact, he was the person who gave him this guideline of becoming architecture. And he told him to draw so many things, because few things, so he drew it in a very proper manner. So in this way he became an architecture. I look at the client's face, his clothes, the way he talks and pronounces, the way he eats, and I would know what his taste would be like. I can relate to people in a way that would be comfortable. I sketch very spontaneously on a paper on the spot. That paper I give to my people in the office. Now he is telling that, coming to the present, how you decide as to what kind of structure you want to give a client. So the interview is asking that what type of structure your client would like to have. How do you know that thing? He is telling, I look at the client's face, his clothes, the way he talks and pronounces, the way he eats, and I would know what his taste would be like. I can relate to people in a way that would be comfortable. I sketch very spontaneously on a paper on the spot. that paper I gave to my people in the office. So he told, okay, this is the way, this is the natural way, this is the natural way that I find what, that I find spontaneously I draw the paper according to the taste. Children, this is done by the most brilliant person to judge the people taste only by looking at his face, his clothes, the color of his clothes, the way he talks, the way he pronounces, and what he eats. I would like with from his taste that what he would, what type of house or the building he want. He will immediately draw, spontaneously means immediately, he will in a very natural way, he will draw on a piece of paper, okay, and that paper he gave to the to his clients in the in his office. So you see, in fact, what I feel, this is his hard work also, his talent also, and he was God gifted, because very less people, I think hardly any architecture is there that who can draw the map of their house by looking at their face, their eating habits, the color they likes, all this thing. But it was immediately done by Hafiz contractor. Now Miss Bela Raja is asking, you do it instinctively? Instinctively means naturally. Naturally, not coming from training or based on reasoning. It was natural thing. That quality was natural to him. Now, call it instinct, call it arithmetic. Now, he gave the answer. You can call it instinct. That means it comes to me in a natural way. You can call it arithmetic also. That means what type of house they want. With the help of the arithmetic, I can draw the sketches in my mind. I can think what type of thing they want to the help of arithmetic. Whatever, now it comes to me like mathematics. So he's telling, now it is coming to me like mathematics. Like in mathematics, what happened, the step is thought by a person, what would be the next step, what would be the next step, what would be the next step. In the same way, when he used to look at the people, when he used to see his their taste, their eating habits, their pronunciation, so step by step ideas used to come to his mind that what type of house he want. He want a big house or with a lawn or with a garden, okay, or with a large window or a small window. What type of his house he want. So this, with the subject he has studies also, and something with the help like putting design, construction, psychology and sociology together. So children, all the things which he had studied, he had learned to put design in his archaeology, construction from the archaeology, psychology. Psychology means here, psychology is indicating to the taste of the people. That means what type of choices they had, what type of houses they would like to have. And sociology, that means what type of house are like in the society, what types of building can be seen in the society. So together and making a sketch from all that is mathematics. He told ki I take help from all this thing, and then this idea comes to me like mathematics. Here we almost come to a full circle where Mr. Contractor has derived his own interpretation of mathematics. Now children, like mathematics, he has derived his formulas, his way of doing his work. Okay, almost came to a full circle means, that means he had told from the beginning to an end, the beginning and the end point touches each other as like in the circle. He has told everything from his childhood, the day he was born, what type of taste he had, how notorious he was, how he never used to like to study, but he likes sports, he liked to help other children. Okay, it proves that he was intelligent but not a good student. So taking it from a subject he hated to a subject he now loves dealing with. Now see children, see the last line. How beautiful this line looks to us. I mean to say, how meaningful this line is. Taking it from a subject he hated. Now children, which subject he used to hate much? It was mathematics. So it was the mathematics he hated the most, and now it is the mathematics he loved the most. the child who was not good in mathematics. Now, during when the principal of the college told him that if he will not pass his entrance examination, he will not get admission. So he worked very hard in mathematics. So children, this isn't it this motivating? The person who was so bad in mathematics has become excellent in mathematics by practicing. So Hafiz is a good at drawing the design of a house on the spot. He looks at the client face and the way he talks to know what his taste would be like. Then that building he has to draw on the spot and give it to his client in the office. Children, now what I feel the title is quite appropriate. The treasure within means what? That means Hafiz, nobody was able to recognize him when he was a child. Everybody, all the teacher used to complain that he is not good in mathematics. But children, see, it refers to the hidden talent of every child who has his own style of learning and area of interest. That's contractor, the Hafiz contractor, he had his own style of learning and area of interest. Not every topper in the academics become an achiever in one's life. Every child can achieve greatness in his area of interest. So if you are interested is in anything, children, please do pour it out from your soul. Practice that thing. See, Sachin Tendulkar was not good in his study, but he had become celebrity. Let me give you the example of Amitabh Bachchan also. He was not good in studies, but he became a world famous actor because he has identified his talent. He knew he would be acting good. So you also come with your hidden talent first. You find it out what is the treasure which is hidden in you and take it out and enjoy your life and become successful in life. Thank you. And have a wonderful day. With this, I end my video here.